Hello and welcome along. Today on Cobra Park Farm, we're going to be doing something a little bit different to what we thought we were going to do last episode. In the dying moments of last episode, we suddenly got a great demand for wool. I mean, basically, as I was signing off, a great demand for wool came up. Seeing as wool is one of the most profitable things in the game, and seeing as we have quite a lot of it at the moment, we're going to use this episode to go and sell some of this and make ourselves some money. The first thing we need to do, though, is we need to get a trailer to transport it to the shop. So we're going to jump in the Defender and head down to the shop and buy ourselves a new trailer, as we don't currently have one. So we'll take this down here. And so this is going to be one of those episodes where we spend quite a bit of time in the Land Rover, I think. Which we do from time to time, because I like to try and use this as much as possible. Not least of which because I want to release it soon. But yeah, so, and it makes good testing to be driving it about and seeing if I can use it for various things. So head down to the shop in this. Now we do have a couple of trailers we can buy. We've either got the Humbar trailer that we also have on Sandy Bay, which is 2,500, or we have a new small utility trailer which is 8,500. To be honest, I think I'm going to go with the Humbar. I haven't had a chance to test the utility trailer yet, and we don't actually have any other uses other than this. Transporting bits like this about, so I think the Humbar is probably our best bet. So we'll go and park at the shop and we'll pop in. We won't do this the other way at all. Right, let's go have a word with them in the shop, see what they say. There we go. So we want, I think it's under MISC. Yeah, there we go. So there's the Humbar. 2,450. We do not have one, so we will buy that. It would only cost us £115 to rent it, which is tempting, but to be honest, at 2,500, we might as well have it. We will use it about anyway, so there it is. So we'll go back and hook it up. I'm half tempted to change the colour of the Land Rover, but I think I might do that when it's finished and I have it logoed up. There we are. Oh, and hook up. There we go. Right, so we will take this down to our sheep and load up what we have. Back inside. Let's have a look. Nothing that way. Oh, we do have something that way. We're clear. We're not clear. But, there we go. Yeah, the buttons to look to do a quick look left and right are the same as lowering and raising the trailer. Ooh, not the safest place in the world to pass, really. But we're past them. Ah, there we go. Probably going a little fast to be pulling a trailer. But that's okay. I already have a good idea of what I want to get as a screenshot for our title card for this episode. So we'll see how we can, see if we can set that up at the same time. Right, we're turning in again. And we can hear our sheep. So we are going to buy, well, this should fund quite a few more sheep. So there's our Ford in the correct place. So we'll park this here. Let's have a look at, yeah. There we go. Off and out. Like so. Oh, no, one thing we do need to do. Open the trailer side. There we go. Right. Oh, we need to open the gate as well. Otherwise, we can't get in. So we do have, at the moment, quite a bit of wool. I should just show you, actually. So the great demand for wool has produced a price of over £8,000 a bundle. So that is, sorry, nearly £8,300. So each of these bundles in here, so it's not the whole thing. It's each of these bundles is worth £8,200. So there is 32,000 in one of them, and another 24,000 in the other. This is going to make us a lot of money, this great demand. And we will be able to fit both of these on the trailer. So we'll sell them all at once, so the price won't drop either. So yeah, this is fantastic. This is why wool is one of the best things to do in the game. And it's why sheep were what I bought, were the thing I bought first. There we go. There's one load. And yeah, and why it's worth actually just letting the wool build up until you get a great demand. Right, now what I want to do. Is that is what I want as my title card shop. We'll take a few shots. There we go. In fact, sorry, I'm getting a little into this. That. Yeah. No, so I've got all the ones I want to get. Right. So we want to reverse this back a bit, because we want to be about here, actually. Dropping this off. And we want to make sure we get it in the middle, so it's properly strapped down. And there we go. There's one. So yeah, if we get a few minutes at the end of this, we will go back and we will just finish off the grass work that we were doing in the last episode. I was going to do that all on camera, all off camera, sorry. But to be honest, we're not going to be moving on to the next day in this video. So if we have a few minutes, just to sort of finish off work we were doing and sort of complete it so that you guys can see it. We'll do that, and then we will get the T7 out on what will be the first day of winter. Well, because our sheep actually as well now won't be producing any wool until the spring again. We're going to be cultivating in oilseed radish in the live stream, I think, and probably continuing that into the first episode next Saturday. There we go. reverse. No. There we are. Lift it over the bump. There we go. Right, so we'll just park this up in the shed for now. And we'll get these strapped down and put into and taken down the shop. We don't need this to unload at the shop. And if we did, we have the clerk down there anyway, so that's fine. So there we go. And we'll now strap these down. There we go. And put the side up on the trailer. No, put the side up. Starter up. And away we go. Right, back in cab, because I do like driving inside the cab of this Land Rover. It's a nice place to be, if I do say so myself. And now that I've got it right-hand drive, I do plan to have this both right and left-hand drive. You will be able to buy either from the shop. This Humbar trailer as well, fantastic trailer, really good. A small utility trailer, just to pull behind this, has been something I've been after for a while. It was sorely missing from 15. To have it in 17 so quickly and so early on is an absolute godsend, and it will probably be in most of the maps that I do. Simply because it is such a useful trailer. The exception, of course, will be when I do when I need to use the utility trailer. So if I've got any small mowers or anything like that, or when I get round to using a skid steer. Right. So the wool, I think, is down the side here, or at least it used to be. Yeah, there we go. So we have 17,253 now. Oop. Yeah, and that is taking it. There we go. So now we'll just unclamp these. Like so, and we'll take it back. But that is fantastic. 139. So we didn't make as much as I thought we would. Oh, maybe. Ah, we didn't have such a full trailer. But we only went from... So we only made about 20,000 on that. That surprises me. Yeah, we only made about 22,000. That would suggest that two of those bundles sells for 8,000. That would certainly fit with what we had just about. I'm not sure, actually. We didn't make as much on that as I thought we were going to make, which confuses me. Confuses me greatly. But we will take this back to... we'll take this back down to the... shed down there, because we're not going to use it for much else. I might use it to transport some pallets of seeds and things to fields, which would be quite a good use for it. But at the moment, nope, we're turning, so we don't want to overtake. And it's quite useful for taking bales and things as well. So We will find some shed space down here, I think, and park it up down here. Surprisingly, not as much shed space as I would hope down here. I seem to have filled it quite convincingly. But anyway, we will jump out of this and jump into our tractor. We still have 15 minutes of the episode left, so we will get back out onto the field. Oh, we're in reverse. Get back out into the field and get the rest of our grass collected. I think we'll put the next load of it in here. We put two loads down at the BGA. I think this load we could do with putting into our feed here, because as I said, we only have 5 silage bales. Which is a good start for our cows, but I think in the long term we will probably be doing it with silage in the clamp instead. I think there's only probably a single trailer load to get off the field. So, right, here we go. I think when we actually do the BGA fully, we will probably do it. We will probably do a field of corn, which is what we have in there at the moment, actually. Yeah. I think that will be the way to go to do the BGA more than anything. But for now, we just want to get back on this. Get this completed. Right, so we'll turn it on and we will lower it down. Get it to follow once we are in position. There we are. Turn it on and away we go. Think we will back that off slightly. We've got a nice big turning circle on this now. So we should have no issues at all. And we'll just zoom through the rest of this. And get it cleared up. Getting any of that side bit? Are we getting a very little bit of that side bit? It's amazing how much turning space we have at the top where we've got most of the diagonal compared to down here where we didn't. We're getting, because we got a little bit off the edge of that bit there, we're now taking the rest in one swipe and getting basically 4 rows worth. There we go. I've just realised something. I bet because I was going too fast. Yeah, we've clogged it. There we go. We're just going to have to run back with this again. Wonder how far back we caused the issue. Not too far back, actually. End of this row, by the looks of things. thing is, when I clog it like this, I'm not actually ending up having to do much more work than I would do if I was doing it separately. I'm just trying to avoid having to do it separately in the first place. Want to make it too full, otherwise, yeah, again, we will get it clogged and have to empty it. Right, so we'll control F again, and this time we will use the cruise control to maintain our speed and keep from getting a clogged forage wagon. Yeah, that's too wide. Don't think we can get all of that. We will have a try. Ooh, hopefully without missing any, which we've done, of course. There we go. Row up as much as we can. Let's see if we can row round this corner. There's quite a bit missed down here by the looks of things. Back up. So I'm pleased that we managed to take advantage of the great demand for the wool. I am slightly disappointed by how much money we made from it. I expected to make an awful lot more than that. I'm never quite sure what the price there refers to, because I thought it was individual bundles. It was definitely more than individual bundle, more than the entire crate, the entire I can't think of the word right now. The entire pallet full, sorry. But yeah, it wasn't enough for the entire pallet, but it was enough. It was more than the pallet on its own. So I'm not quite sure what went on there. I may have to look it up and see if I can work out exactly what's going on. But yeah, it certainly seems to be a little bit of a disjoint between the price offered and the price paid. And it could be litres of wool. You wouldn't have litres of wool. Be interesting to see what the wool is stored as. I think we're at 100%. So we'll stop this. This has reached capacity. So again, we need to go and tip this, and then we'll have to catch up behind. I think over winter, we might actually have to plow these grass fields up. They won't grow over winter. This is our last chance to get any grass before springtime, but I think there is an advantage to possibly ploughing up the meadows and replanting them. A, it will increase our yield, but B, I'm not sure that they are the new type of grass that you can fertilise. So we would, you know, it would be useful to us, I think, to increase the yield. I think we might need a bigger forage wagon. There we go. I'll tip that. Kind of fill in that hole in the middle I'm creating. Interest? We are 5% compacted. I think we have a lot more chaff to put in here. Why silage bales is normally the way to go. But to be honest, we have that big pile of grass there. We could probably put some of that in here as well. Oh. Why did it not turn? There we go. A little bit of clearing up. We are not far from finishing off this field. There we go, get that little bit. It was right down this end that it finished. Lift that up and go a little bit faster then. Pick this up. Right, what I'm going to do is, basically, because I want to do a little bit of cleanup as well, we're just going to go round, get this bit in the corner that's been missed before, and then turn sharply and get this bit. There we go. And that gets us a big bit that we didn't have before. I don't know what the silage additives do, whether that makes this, it turns silage quicker in the clamp, or whether it creates silage in the trailer. It would be interesting to find out. And I'd love to know exactly what the difference that using that stuff in this mangle makes. Kind of hoping this, I don't think this is going to get another full trailer full. I don't know. It's a bit, yeah, it's a bit up in the air. But then this job will be done and we can enter winter in the live stream and in next week's videos. Work our way through. So I think there's going to be some forestry at some point. If we're in winter, oh, we are gonna. Yeah, there are various jobs around the farm we do need to do actually. Right, and there we are. Right, so there's not much left down here now, especially if we can get this in one row. Oh, not quite. That's all right. We're coming back. Is that blocked? I think that might have blocked. Shouldn't have. It has. There we go. Oh, we'll just come back round with this, I think. Okay, that's definitely not blocked now. That did pick up. Okay, good. Around we go. Keeping a close eye on the number. What is going on? It's not on, that's why. Didn't turn it on when I put it back in to follow me. Right, so. When I cleared it out, sorry. Yeah, that's alright. We'll just pop through this. Pick this lot up. Pick this lot up as well. 68%. I'm hoping this is going to cover it. There we go. We're going to try and get all of this in one go. We're not going to, though. It's going to be too wide for that, I think. Yeah. So we'll get it in two. And then we'll be all done. Which I don't mind going a couple of minutes longer for. Off, up, fold. And out we go. Take these two in convoy back to the yard and we'll just park up. And then that's where we will end it. I will run this bit down to the BGA. As we're keeping our alternating going, but for now. What we're going to do is we'll turn that off. And I'll just pop over here. And all that remains... Oh, I need something in the middle. All that remains is for me to say thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please give it a like, drop us a comment, and give it a share. And for all the latest streams and videos from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.